Welcome to creating pad tutorial. Pad is one of the sketch based features in Catia. Features are entities you combine to make up your part. Creating a pad means extruding a profile or a surface in one or two directions. The application lets you choose the limits of creation as well as the direction of extrusion. This task shows you how to create a basic pad using a closed profile, the dimension and mirrored extent options. Open the Pad 1 cat part document. You can download the file from the link in the description. Select sketch 1 as the profile to be extruded. Click pad. The pad definition dialog box appears and the application previews the pad to be created. Enter 40 in the length field to increase the length value. You can increase or decrease length values by dragging limit 1 or limit 2 manipulators. The length value cannot exceed 1 million millimeters. Optionally, click preview to see the result. Click OK. The pad is created. The specification tree indicates that it has been created. About profiles. When selecting a profile, keep following points in mind. You can use profiles sketched in the sketcher or planar geometrical elements created in the generative shape design workbench. You can also select diverse elements constituting a sketch. You can find detailed information in the using the sub-elements of a sketch part of this tutorial. If you click pad with no profile previously defined, just click the icon available in the dialog box. You then just need to select a sketch plane to enter the sketcher and then create the desired profile. As soon as you click, the running commands window displays to show you the history of commands you have run. This informative window is particularly useful when many commands have already been used in complex scenarios, for example. Pads can also be created from sketches, including several profiles. These profiles must not intersect like in sketch 2, or you will get selected sketches self-intersecting error message. Select edit sketch icon and make the circle smaller to avoid intersection. Sketch 2, that is to be extruded, is defined by a square and a circle. Applying the pad command on sketch 2 lets you obtain a cavity. You can select generative shape design surfaces and non-planar faces. For more information, refer to Creating Pads or Pockets from Surfaces part of this tutorial. By default, if you extrude a profile, the application extrudes normal to the plane used to create the profile. To see how to change the extrusion direction, refer to Creating Pads Not Normal to Sketch Plane part of this tutorial. If you extrude a surface, you need to select an element defining the direction because there is no default direction. First, select the surface shown and click pad icon. A warning message pops up telling you to choose a direction. Select yes. Right-click the input area and select x-axis. Click OK. Changing profiles. If you are not satisfied with the profile you selected for the pad, note that you can prefer following actions. Changing the reference sketch. Double-click pad 5 and click the selection field. Select sketch 5 as the new sketch. Click OK. Editing current sketch. Double-click pad 5. Click edit sketch. This opens the sketcher. Pick and move the middle point to change the sketch. Once you have done your modifications, you just need to quit the sketcher. The pad dialog box then reappears to let you finish your design. Using one of the creation contextual commands from the selection field, create sketch. This launches the sketcher after selecting any plane and lets you sketch the profile you need. right-click pad icon. Right-click sketch field and select create sketch. Place a rectangle as a profile and click exit workbench. Click OK to finish command. Create join. This option joins surfaces or curves. Select pad icon. Right-click sketch field and select create join. Select two faces as shown and click OK. Click yes in the warning message about setting the direction. Right-click direction selection field and select x-axis. If the extrusion direction is not pointing out, click reverse direction and click OK. Create extract generates separate elements from non-connex sub-elements. Select pad icon. Right-click sketch field and select create extract. Select the face as shown and click OK. Click yes in the warning message about setting the direction. Right-click direction selection field and select y-axis. If the extrusion direction is not pointing out, click reverse direction and click OK. Limits. You will notice that by default the application specifies the length of your pad type equals dimension option. But you can use one of the four other alternatives. Up to next. Up to last. Up to plane. Up to surface. These alternatives will be mentioned in the other parts of the tutorial. Options. You can use pad creation options when necessary. Thick. Adds thickness to both sides of your profile. Click pad icon and select sketch 6. Select thick option. Just keep default values and press OK. Details will be covered in the creating thin solids section of another tutorial. Reverse side. Applies for open profiles only. This option lets you choose which side of the profile is to be extruded. When designing thin solids, the option is meaningless. Select sketch 4 and click pad. This is an open profile. If you get an error message, click reverse direction. The inner bottom face of the hexagon will stop the extrusion. You can use reverse side option to define the solid position. Mirrored extent. Extrude the profile in the opposite direction using the same length value. Double-click the thin pad you created. Select mirror extent. Click OK. Part is mirrored by the sketch plane. If you wish to define another length for this direction, you do not have to click the mirrored extent button. Double-click the same pad again and deselect mirror extent option. Click the More button and define the second limit for this direction. This is all for creating pad command basics. You can continue with the other videos about creating pads, covering pad limit types and other pad-related commands like multipad.